time the Lord speaks. When you and I listen very carefully, the Lord is speaking. And then you listen. Then you hear the following. You'll hear the Lord rebuking sin. If you look at the conversation with Israel, it's total rebuke. Total, complete. It's a complete rebuke. It's really complete. Number four. Every time the Lord speaks, in the Old Testament, the New Testament, when you listen to the Lord, you'll always hear the Lord saying, separation, separation, separation. You'll be separate from them. Separation. Whenever he spoke with Israel, he always separated Israel. When he speaks to the church, he always separates the church from what? From the moral decay of the world. I'm glad we're on TV, they can hear this now. Separation. Can I move on now? Every time the Lord speaks, because of time, when you listen very carefully, you'll always hear the Lord building the kingdom of God in the church, not the kingdom of man. No. The kingdom of flesh. No. No, never. Old Testament and New Testament. Always building the glorious kingdom of God. And so that's why sometimes you may wonder, what are these things that some of your prophets have told you that have essentially built the kingdom of moral decay in the church? You need not be a genius to know. It's all here. Same Bible, I read same Bible you have. Unless you worship another God. But if you worship Jehovah, the God of Israel, the one I worship, he is holy. Oh yes. Oh yes. Can I move on now? Whenever the Lord speaks, when you listen very carefully, you'll hear the Lord saying, but learn to stand alone, even in the church. Stand alone. Oh yes. Why would you fall into sexual sin? Because people in the worship are in sexual sin. Why? Why? Why would Israel begin to do idol worship because the neighbors are worshiping idol? No. Every time the Lord speaks, you can almost hear the Lord saying, hey, 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 learn to stand alone, even in the church, even among the pastors. If you're in a pastor's fellowship and they are busy discussing other things, the women, the money, and there is no agenda for the coming of the Messiah, there is no agenda for repentance, there is no agenda for holiness, he says, you cannot stand before the Lord and say, Lord, in my fellowship, we never talked about holiness. Never. Never. Learn to stand alone, even in the church, even in the house. If there is sexual immorality in the church, you don't have to submit. Can I move on now? Whenever the Lord speaks, if you listen carefully, you hear the Lord saying, you can hear him fine-tuned saying, walk with those going in the same direction. Hallelujah. Walk with those going to heaven. Walk with those going in the same direction. Otherwise, you'll end up in another place. The destinations are always two. Always two. There are only two destinations. One leads to heaven and the other leads to another. I'm not saying you should not evangelize the other people. If you evangelize them, then they cannot convert you into their world. Oh yes, that is the tragedy that the church has faced today. She went out without power. The power is holiness, you know that. Without power, and she was converted. Whether it's in the Old Testament or in the New Testament, whenever the Lord speaks, every time Jehovah speaks, you will hear Jehovah doing this. Look now. Pointing and saying, look, 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 the coming Messiah. Pointing at the coming Messiah like that. Even Old Testament. When he told Moses to take the serpent and crucify the serpent. And he says, and those who shall, when the snake bites, those who shall focus, they shall not die. But then Jesus comes back in John chapter 3 and says, just as Moses crucified, from verse 14 on, just as Moses crucified the serpent, so shall the Son of Man hang on the wood. Oh yes. So every time the Lord speaks, it's always about the Messiah. It's always about Christ Jesus. Even the entry with blood and pouring the blood on the mercy seat on Yom Kippur. That was the foretelling, the foreshadowing of the Christ that would come and atone for the sins of men. Hallelujah. Every time the Lord Jehovah talks, sends a messenger, or speaks, when you listen carefully, you hear as if he's saying this. Don't seek the approval of the world, but of God. And that's where the tragedy is for the church. That is where the tragedy is for the church and the pastors. Today, they want to endear themselves to certain key figures in government, in the city council. They want the world to love them. They want to preach a gospel such that people come say, "Ah, Pastor, I love you, Pastor. When you preach, you are funny. I laugh. I can't wait for Sunday again." Whatever. They like to hear that. But I'm saying that when the Lord speaks, somebody had rather come and slap you. And slap you, say, "Pastor, you hurt me today." Then you know you are preached. Then you know you are preached the gospel. You are cutting off the flesh. Oh yes. I'm just introducing you to the gospel of the cross. I don't know which gospel has been here, but we in these 2 days is going to be deep. The Lord telling Israel, and the church of course, Israel, to always have an eternal perspective in everything you do. Meaning, if you wanted to pick up a phone call, the phone is ringing, and you can see the name. Oh yes. You can see who is calling. And you know this man for lusting at you. Or you know this woman for lusting at you. The Lord is saying that you must question everything you do. You must ask yourself, how does this help my eternity? How does belonging to this pastor's fellowship here or wherever it is, where they have no agenda for repentance in the church, where they are not discussing how to revive the church, how to return the church to him, how does this help my eternity? There are some real questions now. The church is going to have to ask herself real questions. How does doing this help my eternity? I knew that I would meet this church one day. And we're beginning step by step, and then everything will be all right. That's why I said today is the day of change. But now, having given that slight background, because of the condition of the church, having summarized some of the key features, key principles that govern when God speaks to the church. Then, what is the message that the Lord is trumpeting forth from the two golden, glorious spiritual wedding rings in the sky to the church in Trinidad and Tobago? What is the message? Just like I said, whenever the Lord speaks the Bible, we have to go to the Bible. Now listen to this. The Bible promises when the Messiah, look at this now, when the Messiah finished, when he completed the beautiful work at Calvary, he came, took his disciples, and went behind the wall, behind the eastern gate of Jerusalem, and went with them up the western slopes of the Mount of Olives. Listen to this now. And when they had climbed the western slopes, then they came slightly, just a little bit, to the eastern slopes of the Mount of Olives. And while they were standing there, this is what the Messiah did. He lifted up his nail-pierced hands like this to bless them. And when he lifted up his nail-pierced hands to bless them, then all of a sudden, a cloud came and lifted him up and took him and covered him inside heaven. Essentially raptured him. And when that happened, the disciples were in shock. And as they were in anguish, then all of a sudden two appeared, dressed in white. And they asked this, they say, Men of Galilee, why do you look so distressed? Why do you look so anxious? Why do you look so fearful? Know ye not that this same Jesus who has been taken away from you will come back in like manner? Two appeared. The Bible promises that the Messiah would come back. However, when you look at the Bible, there are two comebacks in the Bible. So if the Lord has sent me to this place to announce the coming of the Messiah, the comeback, then which one am I talking about? There is one that you find in Revelation chapter 16, verse 15. Behold, I come like a thief, and blessed is he who stays awake and keeps his garment, his clothes, with himself, that he may not go naked and be shamefully exposed. That is one coming back como ladrón, like a thief. But when you read Revelation chapter 1 verse 7, there is another comeback. And he says, he comes with the clouds, and he says, every eye shall see him, even those who pierced him, meaning even the enemies of the cross, even the enemies of God. Can I read that then? Revelation 1:7, he says, look, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him, and all the peoples of the earth will mourn because of him. So shall it be. Amen. That is another one. The other one I read, like a thief. This one, he says, everybody, including the enemies of Jesus. So which one am I talking about before we go on air? Go off air, rather. Which one am I talking about? I am talking about the coming of the Messiah at the midnight hour like a thief. And the Bible calls it the day of the wedding of the Lamb. Some people have called it the day of rapture. Some people the coming of the Lord. Some people the coming of the Messiah. Whichever way. But the Bible calls it the day of the wedding of the Lamb of God. And let us turn to the book of Revelation chapter 19. So we may now understand the message that the two wedding rings are shouting to the earth. Revelation 19 verses 6 to verse 9. Are we still on air? Somebody will answer me or not. We are still. Let me finish this. Please allow me to say this. Revelation 19 verses 6 to 7 is the message. Look at what he says. Are you ready? He says, when it comes that day, he says, then I heard what sounded like a great multitude, like the roar of rushing waters, he says, and like loud peals of thunder, shouting, hallelujah, for our Lord God Almighty reigns. Then he goes on to say, let us rejoice and be glad and give him glory, for the wedding of the Lamb has come. And his bride has made herself ready. Then he goes on to say, verse 8, fine linen, bright and clean, was given her to wear. Then he says, fine linen stands for the righteous acts of the saints. Verse 9, he says, then the angel said to me, he says, verse 9, he says, then the angel said to me, write, blessed are those who are invited into the wedding supper, the wedding dinner, the wedding feast of the Lamb. And he said, and these are the true words of God. You see, number one, that when it comes to describing the events of the day of the wedding of the Lamb, the day that these two glorious wedding rings are shouting, trumpeting to the earth, to the nations, number one, you see him saying that when that day arrives, there will be historic celebration like never ever before. Why? Because at one time, Christ, the King of Glory, was missing in heaven. He came on the earth to be abused. In other words, ever since then until now, heaven has been waiting. That look, the scars we can see on him, the abuse we can see, but where is the fruit of the cross? He's saying that the day when the church finally enters heaven, that is the day when the kingdom of God will be complete. The fruition, the fruit of the cross will have entered, the price, the reward of the work he did at Calvary. That's why there will be historic celebration. However, when you look deeper at why they celebrate, then you find out that he's saying this, that the day has arrived, and when they look at the bride, the church, she is also ready. So the real reason for that historic celebration is the readiness of the church. And he says that readiness of the church is not some imaginary or some lofty aspiration. He says it is achievable, it's tenable. It's supposed to be realized in the life of the church. He says that the only way heaven will know that the church is ready and celebrate is when they look at her on that day and see that she's wearing the garment of the Lord, the wedding gown. And he's saying that that wedding gown is the righteousness of the church. So I have essentially come to tell you that the Lord is announcing to the nations that behold, the hour for righteousness is here. Righteousness. In other words, I have come to Trinidad and Tobago to announce to this church, to this generation, that look, you are the church of righteousness. You are the generation that prepares the righteousness of God, the garment. You are the blessed people that when the prophets of old saw, they wept. They said, wow, how mighty will be that generation. I see the glory going to them. I see them as a chosen people that receive the Messiah. Ah! Righteousness. You understand that the Lord is saying that when you look at the church today, she has a garment that she got when Jesus died on the cross and resurrected. But he's saying, when you look at her garment, is it fine linen, bright and clean? Lino fino, resplandeciente y limpio. Is it still clean? He's saying that there are certain stains on the garment I need to discuss here today. He has shown me the stains of the garment of the church in Trinidad and Tobago. One of them is sexual sin. And the other one is the false gospel of prosperity. The gospel that sells you the blood. The gospel that tells you God does not need you in heaven. He needs you on the earth here. Ah! How can you teach that without fear of being struck by God? The gospel that tells you that God does not need you in heaven. The gospel that tells you to live better here, wealthy and healthy, longer forever. And yet, he has raised the two wedding rings as a host. But when we now move in our salvation, we should be heavenly focused. The Lord is saying that what a mighty message to bring to Tobago, Trinidad and Tobago, at this hour when righteousness is lacking most. The Lord is saying this to the church. He's saying that the Bible says, make every effort to live in peace with all men and to be holy. And he says, for without holiness, nobody will see Jehovah. Nobody will see the Lord. That's why I'm here. I have come to love the church in Trinidad and Tobago. I have come to tell them that when that day arrives, the Lord will not lower the benchmark. No. He will not lower the standard of holiness. He is telling you that when he sends me here, he has seen certain stains on your garment, and time is also out. The quality of salvation and time. And he's saying this. He's saying that the postmodernism in the church. He's saying that the women worshipping here, smearing Vaseline on their legs, standing here. Short dresses here, showing legs, smearing Vaseline. So the men may look at the legs. And last, he's saying that that gospel is from hell. It's from Satan. How dare you at this hour? How? He's saying that the immoral dressing of women in the church is the undoing of the gospel. He's saying that there is a garment. There is a garment that must be worn. The church must wear that garment on that day. And he's saying that the gospel of the love of money in the Caribbean is number one in the world for sending out the books and the gospel and the DVDs of prosperity. And he's saying that that gospel of prosperity has caused the pastors to have the love of money in the church so they cannot rebuke immorality. When women stand here like this, short, so they smear Vaseline. Then they dance, but they know what they're doing to you. They know what they're doing to you. Because everybody dresses for a reason. They know. They're not crazy. They're wise. They know what they're doing to the man. Or to the lesbian women. Hey! 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 Good morning, Trinidad and Tobago. There is a new day in the house. Hey! I have come. I told you, it takes a lot of courage to invite me. He's saying that somehow the human theology in the church has made the pastors numb to sin. Women can sit with short dresses in front here and open their legs. Excuse me, whose house? Whose house? My God? No, you and I worship two different gods. Oh yes, my God is the Holy One of Israel. He is holy. I don't know which one you worship that tells you, no, I will understand. I understand what? Oh yes. That's why I wanted to come. And the Lord is saying that when you look at the garment of the church in this country, in this nation, one of the big stains is called the false apostles. The apostles that preach the gospel of the stomach. You treat him well, you give him good food, give him money, he will sing you a song. But who will sing the song of Jesus? If everybody is singing the song of good cars, good homes, the Lord wants to bless 10 people. Only 10, that kind of lie. He wants some 10 serious people. Excuse me. Where is the room for that widow that brought a penny in the church? And Jesus said, she has given it all. Did you understand why I've come? I have come because number one, I have seen the coming of the Messiah. Number two, the Lord has already presented John the Baptist and he has spoken with me. Number three, I have come because of time. Number four, I have come because I've seen the garment of the church in this land. You find abortions in the church. The church has become the place for entertainment. How dare you? Was it a joke when Jesus died on the cross? No. No. And he wept. He cried. He wept out like a child. He cried to the Father. The Lord has sent me here because one of the stains you have... I need to talk. Allow me now to open up because I wanted television time. I know they have cut it off now. Can I now move at my pace? Yes, now we are off air, right? We are off air now? We are off. Thank you. Now I can preach here. I don't like it when I'm doing this thing. This television thing. Because do I look like one of them? No. I don't even want anybody to like me. Because I know you cannot. So listen to this now. The Lord is saying that there has to be change in the house. There has to be reforms in the church. He's saying that repentance must be brought back. At the center of Christian worship. Repentance, which is the turning away from sin, must come back to the house. The Lord is saying that sin has now entered the house. And he's saying that if we do not turn away from sin in Trinidad and Tobago, we go to hell. He's saying that hell is a real place where some people will go. And he's saying that those who have circumcised ears to listen, to listen and to do these things as instructed, they will reform now, take another course, and enter heaven. There is a real opportunity here to enter heaven. And he's saying that on this matter of the coming of the Messiah, there are about four, I could say there are four central themes that he's giving to the church now. Can I walk on them now? Because now we are really on our time, right? We are not on television time now. I can really open up now. When you look at the message that the wedding rings are shouting to the nations from the sky, the first message is this. He's saying that there is an event that we have read about. Revelation 19. There is a real event when the Messiah comes. And he's saying that if those wedding rings then go forth and announce to the nations that look, these are the events, these are the symbolism for that event, then he's saying this to you. He's saying that in the heart of God the Father, in his heart of hearts, he already expressed his sense of accomplishment. Accomplishment. He expressed as in, look what I have achieved until now. And he's saying that he is asking that if the Bible says that when that day realizes, there will be such historic felicitation, jubilation and celebration. Meaning, the most important day in the kingdom of God. Then he's saying this. How about you, the church in Trinidad and Tobago? Is that also the most important day for you? He's asking these questions to you. And he's saying that if you too belong to the glorious kingdom of God, then invariably that day must also stand out as most critical to you. Because the bride described there, he's saying that the church is still the bride of Christ. And he's saying that if that day be important to you too, then that announcement there brings forth responsibility on your part. He's asking that heaven is accomplished. Sense of accomplishment. Heaven has achieved. In other words, preparations have been completed. He's asking, how about you? And there are three things I mentioned in that vision. Number one, the amount of time. He made me know the amount of time he has invested in preparing for that day. time. Number two, the amount of effort he has put in. Number three, the amount of heavenly resources he has not held back to prepare for that day. So the question then becomes this: how about the Church of Christ in Trinidad and Tobago? Have you too, if that day be important to you, have you too invested all your life in preparing for that day? Hey, have you really invested all your life in preparing for that day? Number two, have you invested all your life resources, that's your life, in preparing for that day? Number three, how about effort? Have you put in every effort to prepare for this day? Because as far as heaven is concerned, this is going to be the most important day. Why? Because that is the day when finally the fruit of the cross enters into the glorious kingdom of God.
Glory!
Utukufu!
Look at that!
Tazama yo! Tazama yo!
Look at him!
Tazama yeye!
Look at him!
Tazama huyo mtoto!
Look at what he's doing!
Tazama kile anachofanya!
I think he's hearing them!
Nafikiri anawasikia!
It is big here!
Ni kubwa mno hapa!
Let's turn to the camera a bit!
Geukia camera kidogo!
I want to ask you!
Nataka nikuulize!
What happened?
Nini kilitendeka?
massive, grand, mega revival meeting that is coming up in Eldoret. There will be an uncontrollable healing anointing that will strike the meeting and will shock mankind. It will totally bewilder the beholders of that visitation. And I see the Lord coming to heal also the deaf and the dumb. He will loosen their tongues, he will pop their ears open in their largest numbers. The schools of the deaf, when they bring the deaf there, the mute, the Lord is going to heal them in batches, in groups. And it will be a tremendous sight to behold. It will be a shocking moment to see.
Ida.
Huyu ni mtoto wako.
Ni mjukuu.
Anaitwa nani?
Inda Kila Sawandi.
Ako na umri gani?
Miaka 5.
Umetoka pande gani?
Nakuru Free.
Umetoka Nakuru Free. Ehe. Anasumbuka ugonjwa gani?
Okay, na sikio.
Eh.
Hope Tumaini ana umri wa miaka ngapi?
Miaka 13.
Na je, Hope Tumaini ana shida gani?
Hope Tumaini ako na shida ya sikio la kutembea na rahisi.
Glory!
Utukufu!
Look at that!
Tazama yo! Tazama yo!
Look at him!
Tazama yeye!
Look at him!
Tazama huyo mtoto!
Look at what he's doing!
Tazama kile anachofanya!
I think he's hearing them!
Nafikiri anawasikia!
It is big here!
Ni kubwa mno hapa!
Let down to the camera a bit!
Geukia camera kidogo!
I want to ask you!
Nataka nikuulize!
What happened? What?
Nini kilitendeka?
Ah! He's saying,
anasema,
this ear here,
sikio hili hapa,
it's closed or open. This one. One ear has opened, not both.
Sikio moja limefunguka, si yote mawili.
I think this is a developing story.
Nafikiri hii ni hadithi ambayo inaibuka.
is Esageri. Esageri school for the Esageri school for the deaf.
Esageri shule ya viziwi.
This is what I said. Hiki ndicho nalichosema. Big things are going to happen here.
Mambo makubwa yanaenda kutendeka hapa.
I want the audience to see this and this. Which one is open? This one or this one? What? What? I am not good at sign language. What is that?
Nini hicho?
Mbali. Unakuja. So, tell me, this or this?
Hili ama hili lingine?
Only one.
Moja.
Hold on a second.
Moja kidogo.
It's a developing story.
Ni hadithi ambayo imeibuka.
It's amazing.
Inashangaza.
I was following all the buses leaving. I was following.
Nilikuwa nafuatilia mabasi yote yakiondoka Ravine.
So, this. You know, just allow me, please. This one here. Not yet. And this one? What happened? What? This one, what? You can hear. He's saying, I can hear.
Anasema naweza kusikia.
So, hold on a second. So, this one here. Who? This one? No. And this one? What? Was it open? Show me with your sign. Is it open? It's incredible here.
Inashangaza hapa.
This is big.
Hii ni kubwa.
Okay, the sign specialist is here.
Aya, mtaalamu wa ishara yuko hapa.
Esageri school for the deaf.
Esageri shule ya viziwi.
Everybody receive your healing.
Kila mtu pokea uponyaji wako.
We are celebrating the Lord.
Even you.
Hey, she's also. Look at this. What? Look. Two. Look at this here.
Tazama hii hapa.
Even talking.
Hata kuzungumza.
The ears. What is she saying?
Anasema nini?
Can you come on TV here?
Both ears have been opened. She is also talking, my Lord.
Masikio yote mawili yamezibuka.
The glory is here. The glory is here. Glory. 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 Glory.
Glory.
The glory is here.
Utukufu kwa hapa.
The ear, is it okay? This is it.
Ndio hiyo.
This is the world we live in now.
Hii ndio dunia tunayoishi sasa.
The Lord is visiting.
Bwana anatembelea.
This is good.
Hii ni nzuri.
So,
speak, talk to me. Well.
Okay, I want to say, Baba, Baba.
Now.
Baba, Baba.
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 Oh, yes.
Because
she's trying to talk to me.
Anajaribu kunizungumzia.
I was not understanding a bit, but I can pick it.
Sikuwa naelewa yote, lakini naweza kaichukua.
She's saying both ears open. These two have opened.
Masikio yote mawili yamefunguka.
And then
alafu,
she's touching the tongue also say gone like that.
Anaguza ulimi pia anasema imeondoka.
Two have been opened. Well, I can count everything I've had. 9, 10.
Oh yes. Oh yes.
Oh dio.
Oh yes.
Oh dio. Masikio.
The ears are open. My voice is open. Very fast. Everything is happening very quickly.
Masikio yangu yamefunguka.
Very quickly.
Ulimi wangu umefunguka. Kila kitu.
Oh yes.
Haraka.
She summoned my attention.
Akateka umakinifu wangu.
The miracles have now broken out in this place.
Imelipuka mahali hapa.
My Lord,
Bwana wangu,
three more deaths. No, we cannot take it anymore. Let us just allow him to take control. There are four. Okay. Let us just accept it. And another one, my Lord. And another one there. Jesus. I cannot.
Siwezi.
No, I cannot.
Ah, siwezi katu.
I cannot.
Siwezi.
I will not.
Sitaweza.
Jesus. Let us just worship.
Wacha tu tuabudu.
Jesus. The deaf ears can now hear.
Masikio ya viziwi sasa wanaweza kusikia.
What happened to you? The ear, what happened? Close. This or close. This open. And this? Yeah. Also, two.
Both ears are open.
Masikio yote mawili yamefunguka.
He's very powerful. We love him. My Lord, two more deaf ears open.
Masikio, watu wengine wawili masikio vizuri yamefunguka.
I have a special announcement.
Ninalo tangazo maalum.
I have a special announcement to Kenya.
Niko na tangazo maalum kwa Kenya.
The end time revival.
Ufufuo wa nyakati za mwisho.
Has finally exploded out.
Hatimaye umelipuka.
There is no stopping it.
Hakuna kuikomesha.
It is a tsunami.
Ni tsunami.
Tsunami.
Ni tsunami.
It is an avalanche.
Ni tsunami.
It is a tsunami.
Ni tsunami.
Let everything happen now.
Wacha kila kitu kitendeke sasa.
Now we are ready.
Sasa tu tayari.
Let even the dead come out of coffin.
Wacha hata walio wafu watoke kwa majeneza.
Now I feel we are ready.
Sasa na hisi tuko tayari.
Yes. Yes.
Ndio. Ndio. Tuko tayari.
Hey.
Hey.
Let your living waters flow. But this place, let your Holy Spirit come and take control. What has happened, Archbishop?
Nini kimetendeka, Askofu mkuu, bwana wangu?
There are five children here.
Kuna watoto watano hapa.
Two boys and three girls.
Wavulana wawili na wasichana watatu.
From Chikombero School of the Deaf.
Kutoka Chikombero shule ya viziwi.
They were born deaf and dumb.
Walizaliwa bubu na viziwi.
But the Lord God Almighty.
Lakini Bwana Mungu Mkuu Mwenyezi.
God Almighty.
Lakini Bwana Mungu Mkuu.
Opened their ears.
Akafungua masikio yao.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I ask the Lord
nikamuuliza Bwana
to open in bulk
afungue kwa vikundi kwa wingi
Tagara twice they heard When deaf, can you come? All those the ear open, come out.
Wale wote ambao masikio yamefunguka, jitokezeni, kujeni.
We have the television cameras on this side.
Tunazo runinga za kamera za runinga hapa.
So now.
Kwa hivyo sasa.
There are so many deaf ears that have opened.
Kuna masikio mengi ya viziwi ambayo yamefunguka.
This is a flood. Inundation.
Hii ni gharika.
This is a big flood of miracles.
Hii ni gharika kubwa ya miujiza.
This is unbelievable.
at this ear.
Tazama hii hapa.
Even talking.
Hata kuzungumza.
The ears. What is she saying?
Anasema nini?
Can you come on TV here?
Both please? Ears have been opened. She is also talking, my Lord.
Masikio yote mawili yamezibuka.
The glory is here. The glory is here.